How would you like a chance to win some money?
I love that.
All right. I brought it with me. It's my lucky $50 bill. Sorry, it's one of the older 50s. I've had it for so long, I can't seem to lose it. I guess that's why I call it my lucky 50. But we'll get back to the bet in a second. What I need from you is to select a card. So as I spread through the deck, when you see one that you want, I just want you to touch the back like this, okay? I'll spread slow. Whenever you want, just touch the back of any card. This one.
Yes.
Can you hold out your hand like this for me? Yes, because I want you to take that card. Look at it. Don't let me see it, though. Look at that card. Remember it, but don't show it to me. I'll show it to the camera. Don't worry about that. And place it back in the deck right about here. And I've got $50 riding on this card, so really do get an extra chance, take an extra moment and remember that card. Andrea, you can see it too. And can you help me out one more time?
Mm-hmm.
I want you to push that card the rest of the way back into the deck yourself. Just push it the rest of the way back in. Good. So not only did you pick any card that you wanted out of the deck, you pushed it back into the deck yourself. We're going to take it a step beyond that. I want you to shuffle the cards, all right?
Okay.
And as a matter of fact, while you're shuffling, I'll write up the bet. So go ahead and mix those up. I want to put the bet into writing so that there's no confusion. I bet $50. You're doing a great job, by the way. If you shuffle like that, I can't possibly know where your card is. I bet $50 I can cut to your card on my first try. And I'll even sign it so that there's no way I can back out. Okay?
Okay.
Andrea, can you drop that $50 bill in that envelope for me? Now, you might be wondering, why would anybody do this? I practice manipulating cards 2-3 hours a day. And what good is it if I can find a card in a shuffled deck if I can't do it under pressure? So I find betting $50 adds that missing element. And not just any 50, Jay LaDany's lucky 50. Now, you're satisfied those cards are mixed?
Yes.
Because I only get one chance. I'm going to cut the cards like this. And one card comes out of the center of the deck. Don't tell me what your card was. Tell me, was it the 7 of clubs?
Nope.
Hang on one second. Because I didn't screw up the cut. I actually screwed up the bet. Does this say first try?
Yes.
Yeah, that should say second try. I'm sorry. That's just a minor, minor detail. It's sorry. So it clearly, I don't want there to be any confusion.
Okay.
It clearly says, I bet $50 I can cut your card on my second try. So can you hold your hand out over the table? I just want you to push down on that 50, okay? That's all you got to do. I want you to, no, press, keep your hand up.
Oh, okay.
Your job is a stakeholder, okay?
Okay.
If I win, if I can cut to that card, I get to keep it. You have to give the money back. But if I lose, you get to keep it. Here we go. I'm going to try a different cut, and it looks like this. If I cut the cards like this and like this, one card emerges out of the center of the deck. Don't tell me what it was. Was it the 4 of hearts? It's embarrassing. It really is embarrassing. How does it feel to beat a shark? You can keep the 50. It's yours. Open up the envelope. But Andrea, you remember what the card was. Will you tell me, is it in the top 5 or 6, 7, 8 cards?
No.
It's still a good trick if it's within the top 15. Oh, is everything okay?
What?
Oh, is that where, I'm sorry. Is that where that went?
You know, my God.
Getting that 10 in the envelope was not the most important part. The most important part is that I actually still have my lucky 50.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
I know. I would pay you. I would pay you. Because technically, I didn't get it in the second bet, but this contract is all torn up, so I can't validate. I'm sorry. I apologize. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
Very good.